Well, first of all, we have here the core warehouse functions. On one side, we have to receive the products, then make the put away. Then the product will be stored in our warehouse. And finally, we can receive order from our customer, and we'll have to pick the products to fulfill the orders, and then check, pack, and ship. This is a warehouse. This is how it looks like, a conventional warehouse. I mean, with no automation at all. Conventional racks, shelves, jack pallets. This is another kind of warehouse. It's an automated warehouse. Here you can see vertical lift machines, which are very popular. We have also conveyors. Of course, there is a warehouse management system. This is how it looks like the receiving. And this is my software, how it works. So my software works, it's programmed in Python. First, it takes a picture from a camera. It's a normal camera, web camera. In this case, I'm using my cell phone. Take a picture, then process the image, trying to find barcodes or QR codes. QR codes are better for reading, and you can store more information than barcodes. After decoding the code, it looks for that code in the warehouse management system, which is based on a database, MySQL database. And if the code is found, it processes the image and writes the code on the image, and then it send them to the screen. I use Python for programming the whole software. I use a database, MySQL, for storing my data. I'm using a library called OpenCV for image processing. Then I use the ZBar, which is a library for reading barcodes. And I used also a Pictolite system that communicates to the Python through socket TCP IP. And I programmed on Spider, which is development environment. This is how I model the database of my software. I have a table for the products. I call them SKU master, where I store the barcode and the description. It's a very simple table, because in a real warehouse management system, you'll have to deal with the kind of products, maybe the supplier, the weight, the dimension, some special characteristics, like if it is has to be stored in a frozen area, if it's a dangerous product, if you have to take care of the expiration date, maybe batch numbers, serial numbers. So the table is really big in a real warehouse management system. Then I have a shelf table. I use the shelf table for modeling my shelves. There I will store my products. I have the coordinate. That position is associated to a Pictolite. That's why I have a DP address. I also store the stock, I mean the inventory, in the position. But also in a real warehouse management system, we have a lot of different position. We can have an automation, we can have a normal rack, maybe there are some limits like the weight, maybe you can have the accessibility, the time to reach that location. So it's a very complex table. I have also put away order table where I can store the orders I send to my suppliers and I'm expecting to receive them. I have also a pick order table for the orders I receive from my customers, and also a customer table. So let's see how this works. Now let's take a look at MySQL. So let's take a look at the SKU master. As you can see here, I have defined 11 SKU codes, which are SKU 1, 2, 3, 4, EOQ, very important to have all this in EOQ. And now I will try to look for a mean. So in my WMS, the number 4 is for the information. And I can show you here. So my software take a picture and then try to find a QR code or a barcode and then process the image, extract the information, and then look into the database for the code. In this case, it found the SKU02 and there also an image and it's some information. I have a zero inverter, zero amount of milk. Let's see more clear here. Yeah, it's bigger. And now let's try another product, which is cream. Okay. Now let's take a look at the put away order. It's a table. So as you can see here, I have from SKU01 one unit to receive. That's the we have received. We have to store into our warehouse. I have 4 units of SKU02. Which is SKU02. I can take a look at SKU master table. It's a milk. So in my warehouse, I can just press 2, which is put away. Now I have to read the SKU number 2. So as you can see here, you see that there are 4 units. I have to store 4 units of mail here. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4 units. Now I can confirm by pressing this button. Okay, it's confirmed. So let's take a look again at the put away order table. So as you can see here, we have received 4 units already received, and this is the time I received that order. I can make the same with another code just to see how it works. SKU number 4, which is cream, and 2 units. 1, 2, press this button, and again, I'm going to refresh. Okay, sorry. Okay. So, I have received 2 units of cream 1 minute late. So this is the how this put away works. In a real warehouse, it's very, very, very difficult to make this decision. because you have a lot of products. Some products have to go to the normal shelves, some of them has to go to the rack, some of them has to be stored in a frozen location, some of them are dangerous, maybe special treatment like explosive, like so it's very, actually it's a very complicated operation, and you have to make a lot of tags. You have a forklift truck, you have a check palace, you can have a lot of different material handling equipment for dealing with it, this operation. This is just a simplification. So now we are going to try this function, which is count by light. So I have 4 units of milk, 0 in the position number 3, 2 units in the position number 4, and 0. So I have this table, which is shelf. Let's take a look. And here we have the stock 4, 2. Count status, it started to count, and the data that it was counted, so I can just confirm. Okay, as you can see here, it was counted at this time, and the amount before counting it was 4, and after counting it was also 4. There's no difference in counting, but let's see what happens if we have a difference. So let's try to count. Instead of 4, I have 3. This is 0, it's okay. This is 2, okay. 0, 0, 0, 0. 0 here, and I can use this button to change the amount of products in this position. In this case, I have 3. I confirm, finished, and let's see my table. Now you can see that I have only 3 units of stock. Before counting it was 4, and then after counting 3. So here I can check the difference in stock. Now let's try the last function, which is the picking. So I have to press 1, which is picking, and now I have to read the order code. But first, let's take a look at the database. Here are the picking orders. I have 2 orders, 111 and 333. I will try the order 111, which has 2 lines, one for SKU 02 and the other for SKU 04, 2 units and 1 unit. Let's see if we have enough talk. Yes, we have 3 units and 2 units. I think it's enough. So let's try the picking. Okay. So now, as you can see, displays are showing that I have to pick 2 units of milk and 1 unit of cream. So let's try first. 1 unit of cream, I will press. So now it's green because I already confirmed. And let's take a look at my table. And now number 2. Okay, as you can see, there was to pick. It's already finished at this time. You can see here also the communication between the DPDs, the socket, and we also can see in our shelf that I have only 1 unit of milk and 1 unit of cream. I can use my software just to count. So now 1 unit of milk. Yes, I picked 2 before. And I can just confirm. Yes, very nice.